Ah, new world boxing sensation Randy Caballero, right here in Indio, California, and I caught up with him to talk some boxing. Where, how you doing? How's life?
Doing good, good, feeling good. Just got done with the fight. Now it's time to take a little break and see what's next.
It was an insane weekend of boxing, from Abner Mares to, of course, you had Cota Margarito to your fight. Tell me about your fight, for those who didn't see it, those who missed it.
You know what, it was a great fight. A guy coming from Puerto Rico came to fight. He trained hard. I'm not taking anything away from him. He came to fight. I know he wasn't going to go out easy, and he was tough. He came forward, tried to put pressure, a little dirty in times, but it was a learning experience for me. We train different in this training camp, and I work with those kind of things inside the ring, so I felt real good. It was a different me in that ring, and I felt real good.
And how did it go? How did it end?
Good. I came out with the win, decision. You know, it's defending my title, so there's no way I was going to let that thing go.
What's the record right now?
13-0 and 7 knockouts.
How does that feel?
Feels good. Feels good to know I'm undefeated, staying undefeated. I'm going to make sure I keep training hard so I stay undefeated and show Golden Boy I'm ready for those bigger and better fights out there.
Now, you're one of the sparring partners, one of the people who train with Nonito Donaire. People say Jorge Arce told me he's the best pound for pound in the world. What's it like for you to train with Nonito?
It's a great experience. You know what? Being in the ring with him feels good, knowing that, you know, he's the best fighter out there right now. And I just love being inside that ring with him. It's something different compared to the guys that I spar here in the Valley, in LA, and stuff like that. He's just fast with his feet, you know, his hand speed's there and everything. So it's a great learning experience for me.
Did you see any other fights this weekend? Do you have a chance to catch him?
I seen all the fights. You know what? Cotto, Margarito. I was going for Cotto. Cotto's, you know, I love watching Cotto. Cotto has a heart, and that's what I love about Cotto. And he's a tough fighter. You know, it's hard to make him quit. And that's what I love about him, and I was hoping he came out with the win, and you know what he did? He did what he had to do. He looked beautiful doing his boxing in there, inside that ring, and outboxing Margarito.
What do you say about Brandon Rios' fight?
Oh, man, that was a good fight, too.
Hard to watch, huh?
Oh, yeah, war. Definitely, man. Brandon Rios always goes in there and puts on a war for everybody. He's a tough fighter. There's no way you're going to push Brandon Rios back. He always comes forward. Tough guy, man. I love watching him fight.
At the same time, those fights were going on. Did you watch Mares Agbeko?
I watched that one too. We were
back and forth. You know Abner very well?
Oh, yeah, definitely. We spar Abner Mares. Love working with him. You know, totally different to Nonito. You know, comes forward, put pressure, typical Mexican fighter going forward. But, you know, I love working with him too. And the fight was really good. Good fight.
Fight of the year, maybe? Candidate?
Yeah, it could be up there.
Well, he got injured early. You thought it may be stopped after two rounds. He came back and he boxed him, got the unanimous decision.
He looked really good, impressive.
So what's next for you now?
Whatever Golden Boy has, all I do is train in that gym, stay 100% inside the gym, and whatever they put in front of me, I'm ready for.
So there you have it, Randy Caballero. Look out for him. Stay tuned for more for YesNewsReporting.com. I'm Melissa Sack reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, @SackPack.